by now, the world was starting to realise just what Hitler was and what he represented.
On the 4th of October 1936, I was only a lad of 16. But I stood beside men who were 80 and every age in between. We were dockers and teachers, busmen, engineers, and those with no jobs to do. We were women and children, equal in union, atheists, Christians and Jews. And we had so much to lose. For with Hitler in Germany, Franco in Spain, we knew what fascism meant. So when Mosley came trouncing, denouncing the Jews to the East End of London, we went. For I'd met refugees who had fled overseas, Germans, Italians and Jews. And I knew their despair for what they'd seen there, and I couldn't let them be abused. We had so much to lose.
The rallying call evidently had gone out, and there was thousands and thousands of people, from dockers to nurses and doctors. The British people in London were not going to let Mosley and his fascist thugs do it, even if he had the support of the police.
Now 3,000 fascists, their uniforms black, had set out to march on that day. And 6,000 policemen intended to greet them by making clear the way. But we were there ready, our nerves, they were steady, 100,000 in mass. And we planted our feet along Cable Street, and we sang, "This shall not pass." We sang, "This shall not pass." Then all those young lads, we were sent to the side streets to stop the police breaking through. And with swift hands we made strong barricades out of anything we could use. And they came to charge us, but they couldn't barge us with fists, batons and hooves. With as good as we got, we withstood the lot, for we would not be moved. We would not be moved. And yes, there was violence, and yes, there was blood, and I saw things a lad shouldn't see. But I'll not regret the day I stood, and London stood with me. And when the news spread, the day had been won and Mosley was limping away, there were shouts, there were cheers, there were songs, there were tears, and I hear them all to this day. And we all swore then we'd stand up again for as long as our legs could. And that when we were gone, our daughters and sons would stand where we stood. Was the first time I'd heard two tiny words said by every woman and man. And now I say them still, and I always will. No passer.
by this time I'd realised myself. The old question of wanting a better world, that was only one person was going to do it, that was myself in cooperation with every other single person. The war in Spain was going to become such an historical event. Well, I was 17. I knew that I wouldn't get to Spain for my age. Non-intervention was the law and the rule at the time. And to go into Spain as a volunteer was against the law of Britain. I went to this address, knocked on the door, and a little window box opened on this door. Yes, who are you? I've got an appointment with a man called Robson.